Okay, so let's discuss receivable financing. So what do you mean by receivable financing? Wrong spelling, Pajod. Okay, receivable financing. So basically, di ba financing? We finance through our receivables. Okay, we generate funds through our receivable. Okay, so again, receivable financing. So we generate cash through our receivables. So basically, receivable financing is the financial flexibility or capability of an entity to raise money out of its receivable. So therefore, it's a financial flexibility and capability of an entity to raise money, to generate money throughout its receivable or using their receivables. So basically, during general business decline, so an entity may find itself in tight cash position because sales decrease and customers are not paying their accounts on time. So during business decline, so let's say for example, during COVID times, di ba, a lot of businesses are affected. Their sales are dropping at the same time. Siguro, tato ilang mga receivables from their customers wala pa nang bayaran. 'Di ba? Sales are dropping, wala pa collection sa receivable, but their current obligations is naagyapon, ongoing, 'di ba? So, di drop ang sales, wala pa collection, pero naagyapon ang mga expenses, naagyapon ang mga bayro nun. Okay. Maningin yung dahil that entities, current accounts, and notes payable must continue to be paid if its credit standing is not to suffer. So, even though ni-decrease ang sales, walay collection sa ilang receivable, but their accounts payable and their notes payable, naagyapon, they need to pay their current obligations. So, one way for the entity to generate cash just to pay their current obligations is through receivable financing. So, unsa naitabo sa receivable financing? So, si entity nangutang og kwarta kang banks by refinancing their receivables. Okay, so we have different forms of receivable financing. So, first is you have pledge of accounts receivable. Second is you have assignment of accounts receivable. Third, you have factoring of accounts receivable. And fourth is discounting of notes receivable. So, atong gisurihan din nga receivable is we're talking about our AR and our note receivable. Therefore, in times of tight cash position, naglisod ta og cash, but we have our expenses, we have our current obligations to pay, pwede na ito gamiton sa AR o note receivable para maka-generate of cash. In what way? So, first is pledge of accounts receivable. Kung sa'yo naitabo sa pledge of accounts receivable, di ba? By word, it's a pledge. So, kung sa'yo naitabo diri, all accounts receivable serve as collateral security for the loan. Okay, so naitabo sa pledge of accounts receivable because we badly need cash for our daily operations and to pay for our maturing obligations. So, gi-pledge na to ang AR na to. So, by pledging AR, ato siyang gi-collateral. Kinsa na to siyang gi-collateral sa atong utang. So, we go to financial institutions, nangutang ta, and para makautang ta, atong gi-pledge, gi-collateral ang atong accounts receivable. Okay, siyempre sa part ni bank, dili magpautang kung walay collateral. So, unsa atong gi-collateral, our accounts receivable. Pwede din na, sir. Yes, pwede siya. Di ba, we collateral or we pledge the accounts receivable. Under pledging of accounts receivable, no entry would be necessary. Okay, because mura raman sa nagkisabot lang ta kang bank na bank pautang ako akong i-collateral ang akong receivable sa imo. Okay, so it is sufficient that disclosure thereof is made in note to financial statement. So no entry would be necessary if gi-pledge lang nato ang atong accounts receivable. But we need to disclose it in our notes to financial statement. So kinahanglan sa dapat naka-explain dito na naay person or naay receivable namo nga naka-pledge or naka-collateral for the specific loan. So by pledging your accounts receivable, nakautang ka. Therefore, naatay cash nga nadawat from the loan by pledging our accounts receivable. So if nanatay cash, pwede na tayo bayad sa atong mga current obligations and operations or operational expenses. Yes, bago lang nag-start, this is the first okay, it's okay. This is recorded, so i-upload mo po na ako ni. Okay, so that is pledge of accounts receivable. So again, there is no necessary entry for pledging of your AR, but you need to disclose. Take note that under pledging of accounts receivable, all accounts receivable atong gi-pledge. Okay, all accounts receivable. Okay. As illustration dira sa libro, ang gi-provide dira niya, actually, di ba, because there, no entry would be necessary for pledging of accounts receivable, ang mga entries nga nadira is sa loan na part. Di ba, so, kung nangutang ka, you receive cash, you debit cash, you credit the notes payable for the bank, or if discounted ang imong note, or naay gikuha si bank nga advance interest. Okay, so napunta gitawag discount on note payable. So I will not further discuss pledge of accounts receivable because again, no entry would be necessary under pledge of accounts receivable. So disclosure lang ang required, it is sufficient na pag nanay disclosure. Next type of receivable financing is assignment of accounts receivable. So we are assigning our accounts receivable. So basically, borrower, assignor transfers rights in some specific accounts receivable to a lender called assignee in consideration for a loan. So in this case, actually, assignment of accounts receivable is a formal type of pledging your accounts receivable. Formal siya because naagid kay agreement, di ba, na ay financing agreement and a promissory note in which kita as assignor signed. So, anay tabo diri sa assignment, di ba, kita ni, naatay receivable kang customer nato, si customer, natay AR, since naglisod ta, di ba, naglisod ta, lisod atong cash. So, sa atong gibuhat to generate cash para makabayad po ta sa atong mga current obligations, nagloan ta kang bank. Si bank. Pero pag loan ni mo kang bank, unsa imong gibuhat? Di ba, you assigned your accounts receivable. So, ang naitabo diri karon, kita, nahimutang assignor slash borrower kang bank. Kaya gi-assign na to atong AR kang bank. Tapos si bank nahimong assignee or lender. Okay, so nainitabo, natay customer, natay receivable sa iya. But since naglisod ta to generate cash, tapos natay kinalan bayaran ng currently maturing obligations, so atong gibuhat, gi-assign na to ang atong AR, o bank, pa-loan ako bank, ako lang i-assign ang akong AR. Diba? Some sort of collateral dira sa imo para mapautang ko nimo. So, by assigning our AR to the bank, karon gitawag na ta as assignor, the same time, borrower. And si bank, siya ang assignee, siya itong gi-assignan, and siya po sa lender. Under assignment, specific AR lang atong gi-assign. Diba? Specific AR lang, so person lang of your accounts receivable were assigned to the assignee. Unlike sa pledge kagaina, diba, all, tanan receivable imong gi-collateral para makautang ka to generate cash. So, dire, specific lang ang cash na atong, ang AR nga atong gi-assign kay to the assignee or the bank or kang lender para makautang ta. Okay, natay gitawag under assignment, non-notification basis and notification basis. Si pasabot ani, di ba? From the word itself, notification. So, under non-notification basis, customers are not informed that their accounts have been assigned. The customers continue to make payment to the assigner who in return remits the collection to the assignee. While notification basis, customers are notified to make their payments directly to the assignee. So, ang sinaitabuan ni, di ba? In this case, sang i-delete. Okay, we have non-notification basis and notification basis. Under non-notification basis, di ba, kita ang naay collectable AR kang customer. Tapos, ang katotong collectable kang customer atong gi-assign kang bank. Under non-notification basis, wala na to gi-inform si customer, uy, customer, ang akong receivable sa imo, akong gi-assign kang bank. Wala na to sa gi-inform. So, ang may tabo, since uninformed, non-notified si customer, sa mubayad. Kinsa sa mubayad, sa ato or kang bank. Okay, the answer is, okay, sa ato, because wala ta nag-notify kang customer nga, oy customer, ang AR na imo, ang AR na ako sa imo, akong gi-assign kang bank, wala ta nag-inform sa iya. Therefore, si customer, wala kabalo, hasil mo bayad, sa ato sa mo bayad. So what happens, pag mo bayad si customer sa ato, kita pod, nga natay utang kang bank, atong i-remit kang bank. Diba, bayad si customer sa ato. Inani may tabo sa notification basis, diba? And non-notification basis. Since wala kabalo si customer, mubayad si customer sa ato. Bayad si customer. Kita po, kita ang mo-remit kang bank. Since nangutang ta, diba, atong gi-assign ang AR. Kato nga specific AR kang bank. Okay, under notification basis, pasabot, na-notify si customer nga, uy, customer, ang AR na ako sa imo, ako rabang gi-assign kang bank. So, aware siya nga naka-assign kang bank. So, unsay buhaton ni customer, diritso na siya, pwede sa dito mo diritso og bayad kang bank na. Because, informed siya, na-notify siya, na ang iyang bayro nun sa ato was assigned to the bank. So, automatic, si customer, mubayad diritso kang bank because he was notified. Okay, that's the difference between non-notification basis and notification basis. Okay, accounts receivable assigned or accounts receivable assigned account is still part of trade and other receivables as part of the accounts receivable. So, unsay mahitabo, di ba? Because we assign portion of our AR to the bank. Para lang makautang ta. So, may tabuan na nanatay duha ka AR karon. Your AR nga original, napunta kita nga AR assigned. Kanang AR assigned, that's part of the whole AR. So, kumbaga, this is the total AR, yung composition, AR nga, wala na assigned, AR nga assigned. Okay, So, saan na ito pag-account ng accounts receivable assigned account? So, si AR assigned. How do we account? Actually, it's still part of the trade and other receivables account. Na-otrolay ang pangalan. Nalang na sinasumpayan niya assigned. Okay, as part of the accounts receivable. Take note that under pledge and assignment, we are still the owner of the receivable. No, we are still the owner of the receivable because sa pledge, di collateral lang nato, kita gihapon ang owner sa AR. Under assignment, gi-assign lang nato. Kita gihapon ang owner sa AR. That's why it's still part of our accounts receivable under trade and other receivables. Kanilang siya, nalay na nadugang sa AR nga assigned. Okay, naka-assign ni siya nga specific AR, okay, for the loan. What if na ay doubtful account sa specific AR nga gi-assign sir sa loan? So the doubtful accounts should be accounted for under your AR assigned. Let's say for example, doubtful accounts, di ba? Ang entry sa doubtful accounts, okay, dae, ada, dapat naka-assign because this is related to your assigned account. Okay, di ba? This is the entry if nae doubtful for collection. So, dae, ada, imong ada, dapat nae assign. Okay, para pag compute nimo sa net realizable value niya, so AR assigned minus ADA assigned, oh, that is your NRV on specific or on the assigned accounts receivable. Okay, so kana siya kung na doubtful sa katong na-assign, related na po siya sa assigned. So i-match na to siya sa katong na-assign po siya. Okay. So, under assignment, napuntay another formula nga ni under formula dire. So, you have accounts receivable assigned balance. Katotong gi-assign balance sa pilay na bilin ato. Okay, basin dahi sa atong gi-assign na ay na-collect, na ay na-write-off, na ay doubtful for collection, or na ay na-recover. Pwede na siya. Okay, so balance minus the note payable bank balance, which is kato atong giutang, pilay balance ato, then the difference is equity in assigned accounts. So that is how you compute equity in assigned accounts. So when you say equity in assigned accounts, it's balancing figure, di ba? Residual value, because di ba? Asset minus liability is equal to equity. So, money siya. But this equity in assigned accounts is not presented in your financial statements. It is only disclosed in the notes to financial statements. So, i-disclose lang siya nga na equity in assigned accounts of this amount. Okay, so that is assignment. So, again, assignment, it's a formal type of pledging but dire, naka-specific lang AR. Portion of your AR were assigned, di ba, para mangutang ta. Okay, so we have notification basis and non-notification basis. Let's have an example. This is provided in the book. So this is non-notification basis. So pasabot non-notification, customers were not informed that their AR were assigned to the bank or to the financial institution. So here, an entity assigned 700,000 of accounts receivable to a bank under a non-notification arrangement. So, 700,000 of our AR were assigned to a bank, di ba? Para mangutang takang bank. But the bank advances 80% less service charge of 5,000. Normally, si bank or the financial institution dili sa 100, dili niya 100% or dili 100% ang iyang iha ipautang sa ato. Okay, so di ba parehaan eh, 700,000 atong gi-assign, but ang i-grant lang ni bank sa ato is only 80% of that 700,000 plus napag-service charge of 5,000. Okay, so muna siya nga, dili gid na 100% normally ang ginatag ni bank. or equal to your AR assigned. Why? Because what if na I returns, what if na I discount, what if na I allowances, diba? Unsaon niya pag-recover if iyang ihatag tanan ang 100%. So, on the part of the bank, nagpun sa mga reservations niya na dili at 100%, kung pila imong yasay, mapun akong ihatag sa imo. So, less than gina siya. So, that's 80%. Tapos na pag-service charge. Plus, the entity signed, yes, for security purposes on the part of the bank. Okay. So, the entity signed a promissory note that provides for interest of 1% per month on the unpaid loan balance. So, aside pag yun, sa less than 80, sa 80% lang tapos na service charge ng 5%, syempre, nangutang ta. So, since nangutang ta, nagid na interest na itong bayaran. So, the entity signed na with interest of 1% per month on the unpaid loan balance. So, 1% per month. Okay, first ato buhaton, separate the assigned accounts. Since this part of our AR, ang 700 atong gi-assign. So, unsay gibuhat nato, di ba? O, nag debit tag accounts receivable assigned, gibawasan nato ang atong regular nga accounts receivable. So, it's still part of your AR, but ato lang siyang gi-classify karon, nanay assigned, nanay katong regular. So, that's 700,000. 700,000. To record the loan, pila lagi ka percent ang loan? Okay, di ba? That's 700,000 times 80%. That is 560,000. So, mara ni atong liability. Mara ni gipautang sa ato. But, sa 560,000 nga atong giutang, pila ray cash atong nadawat? So, only 555. Why? Because, di ba, na-i service charge nga 5,000. Okay, so, gibawasan na ni bank. Oh, number 5. Issued a credit memo for sales return to a customer whose account was assigned 20,000. So, nahitabo karon sa imong 700,000 nga gi-assign na ay 20,000 ato nga giuli sa customer. So, sales return to a customer whose account was assigned. So, timing naka-assign siya na ay giuli si customer. So, sa tumbuhaton, diba, sales return entry, debit sales return, credit AR. But this time, same entry, debit sales return, credit AR, kato na kang assigned. 20,000. Okay, i-minus sa 700,000, sir, ang kanang return. Diba? Based on the entry, we credited the accounts receivable assigned. If we prepare the T account for the AR assigned, diba? T account takang AR assigned, gain na naatay 700,000 debit. Karon, na i-return, i-credit taog AR assigned. So, that's 20,000. So, kung as of sending a month. As of April 5, pila yung balance atong AR assigned. So, that's 680 na lang. Okay, diba? Based on the entry, we credited the AR assigned account. So, basically, it will be deducted to your AR assigned. Okay, next. Collected 30,000 of the assigned account. Less 2% discount. So, nakakolekta taog 300,000 from the 700,000 AR assigned. Take note that this is non-notification basis. Diba? Non-notification eh. So, kita ang nag-collect because wala na-notify si customer na na-assign na dahil ang iyang AR. So, si customer sa ato nagabayad. Kita lang ang murimit kang bank in payment sa atong loan, sa atong giutang. So, in this case, there is collection of 300,000 of the assigned accounts na pag 2% discount. Diba? Normal entry, if there is discount, diba? We debit sales discount at 2%, we credit cash, which is net of discount, we we debit cash, which is net of discount. Then we credit the accounts receivable again assigned at 300, because this is the whole AR. From the whole AR, na ay 2% discount. That's why we debit sales discount. Ang cash nga to na dawat is only net of discount. So since the notification upon payment of the customer sa ato, atong role ani karon, mubayad ta kang bank. Diba? So, i-remit na ito kang bank ang atong collection. Okay, so, nitabo at the end of the month, remitted the total collection to the bank plus interest for 1 month. So, diba, nangutang ta. We have 1% interest per month based on the unpaid balance. Pila itong giutang? 560,000 ra ang gigrant niya. So, times 1%. Okay, that is 5,600. Therefore, on April 30, at the end of the month, aside sa i-remit na ito ang atong na-collect from the customer, we also need to pay the interest for the loan nga atong giutang. Diba? So, tanawa yung entry, pila ang na-collecta gani nato? So, cash nga itong na-collecta is only 294,000. So, pila itong i-remit? 294,000 plus the interest of 5,600. That's why ang total lang atong gibayad nga cash diri is 299,600. Diba? That is collection from the customer plus the interest expense for 1 month, which is 1% times the unpaid balance. Okay, so note payable bank, 294 lang ito nabayad sa iya. Then, nai-interest na 5.6. So, pilay balance karon sa itong note payable on April 30. This is the note payable, 560. So, atong nabayad is only 294,000. Therefore, napatay balance of 266,000. Okay, let's proceed. Okay, so that's for April, ha? That's for April 30. So, naapay transaction sa May. Starting May, or on May 7, assigned accounts of 15,000 prove worthless. So, nag-write off ta. Part of the 700,000 na 15,000 ato, nag-write off because it was prove worthless. Diba, on say entry pag na-I write off, diba, debit, ADA, credit accounts receivable assigned. So, therefore, debit ADA, 15,000. Credit AR, related to the assigned accounts, 15,000. Then, after, on May 20, nag-collect na punta. Collected 300,000 of the assigned accounts. So, therefore, since collection siya cash, credit AR assigned, 300,000. Since nakakolekta, this time, sa itong next button, di ba, i-remit kang bank. Okay, we need to remit it to the bank. But the question right now, pila itong na-collect, pila balance na to sa itong biro noon. Di ba, itong balance is only 266 na lang. Tapos, pila itong na-collect na din, 300. Therefore, question, i-remit ba nato tanan kang bank? I-remit ba nato tanan 300,000 kang bank? Okay. Of course, sir, dili. Ano man, atong utang, sir, 266 na lang. Pero atong na-collect, 300. Atong bayaran, ana, sir, ang 266 na lang. Okay. So, ang sinitabo, diba? So, girimit na to, diba, gibayaran na to ang 266 plus the interest. Because the interest is 1% on the unpaid balance of the loan. So, pilay balance na to, gagayin na to 66,000 times 1%. Yes, times 1%, that is 2,660. So, napay-interest. Tapos, ang cash is 268,000. Therefore, napag-yapoy nabilin sa ato. Diba? 300 ato na-collect. Tapos, 268,660 lang atong gibayaran. So, napay nabilin sa ato. Nga cash from... So, ato na to. Okay. Since na fully paid naman na to ang atong bayro nun. Okay. to transfer the remaining balance of assigned accounts to accounts receivable. So, syempre, nahuman naman, di ba, nabayaran na to ang loan, ako na pong ibalik ang atong AR, ibalik na to kang atong AR assigned to original AR. Bali, dira po ko ako ng interest, sir. Yes, interest, di ba, ingon sa dire, sa problem, interest is 1% per month on the unpaid loan balance. So, di ba, April 30, pilay balance sa imong loan, 266 na lang. So, dire ka mo times of 1%. 266. Okay, so again, dire, kung mag-T-account ta sa itong AR assigned, napabay nabilin. Di ba, 700 to. Based on the entry, 700 na ay return nga 20,000 credit, tapos na 300,000 collection. So, butang sa nato ha, 20,000 sales return, 300,000 collection, na ay write off, now 15,000, tapos na atay another collection na 300,000. Napabay na bilin? So that's 700 minus 20 minus 300 minus 15 minus 300. So napatay na bilin nga 65,000 AR assigned. Since na bayaran naman nato ang loan, so ibalik na nato sa AR nga regular nga normal. So para mabalik siya sa tong buhaton, so i-zero out nato ni, so mag-credit ta og AR assigned. Debit tag normal nga AR, that's 65,000. Di ba kay kung ato sa ibutang sa T account niya nga 65,000, amo sa adjustment since nahuman naman iyang purpose, di ba? Di ba ang purpose nganong gi-assign nato para makautang ta tapos nabayaran na nato ang utang, ibalik na nato sa to regular AR. Ibalik na sa regular AR. Pero again, pag mangutan na pilay total AR, AR regular plus AR assigned, maghapon ang answer. So kanilang, gibalik lang nato siya because naman naman yung purpose. Wala na yung naka-assign because na fully paid na siya. Okay. So, question so far for assignment. That's non-notification basis, ha? That's non-notification basis. So, sa ato gihapon nagbayad, si customer, kita lang ang mo-remit kang bank. Okay, walay question? How about notification basis? Diba? So under notification basis, we notify the customer na ang AR ato nang gi-assign kang bank. Therefore, since notified sila, customer will pay directly to the bank. So di na siya moagi sa ato. So this is the sample problem as illustrated in the book. So nag-assign data og 1 million of AR to a bank under notification arrangement. Ang gipautang lang ni bank sa ito is 80% of the assigned. So, that's 1 million times 80%. So, only 800,000 lang ang gipautang. Tapos, 94% service charge on the gross amount assigned. Therefore, 4% service charge based on the 1 million. So, that's times 4%. That is 40,000. So, aside sa 800 gipautang, mabawasan pa siya og 40,000. Pilaray na dapat itong nga cash, so only 760,000. The entity signed a promissory note that provides for nanapoy interest per month on the unpaid yapon loan balance. So on July 1, nag-assign ta, di ba, entry na to, o gibagi, nag-debit tag-assign, credit tag AR 1 million. Tapos, pila na ito na-collecta from the bank na ito na-utang. Gipautang tag 800,000 but because naya service charge, ang cash nga ito na dawat is only 760. You have the service charge and you have the note payable to the bank. Diretso na ni sa bank, sir. What do you mean by diretso na sa bank? Ang diretso sa bank, oh yes, dili na ta mag-remit because na-notify naman na to si customer. So si customer, kabalo na sa aha sa mubayad. So dito na sa mubayad kang bank diretso because notified sila. Unlike kagaina nga wala sila kabalo, sa ato gid sila mubayad. Kita ang mo-remit kang bank. So direct na ang payment ni customer to the bank. Oh, so tanaw sinaytabo. Received notice from the bank that 600,000 of the assigned accounts were collected less 2% discount. So nahitabo karon si bank ang nag-inform na sa ato. Uy. Isa man ta. Uy. Kasi may panganan eh. Uy entity. Katong gi-assign nimo sa ako nga 1 million. Nagbayad na ang katunga cost, nagbayad na imong customer 600,000. Pero katong 600,000 nga imong gi-assign sa ako nga AR naay 2% discount na claim si customer ato. So, nahitabo, akong nakolekta sa imo is only 98% lang. So, 98% lang po ang akong i-minus sa imong utang sa ako. So, ningon si bank. So, kita ang gi-inform ni bank na nagbayad imong customer 600,000 pero less 2% discount kay cover the discount period. So, unsa tong buhaton? So, since nagbayad si customer dito, automatic, nabawasan natong liability. Nag-debit tag note payable bank. Pila, that's 98% because na ay discount. So, 588 lang tapos record tag sales discount because na 2% discount i-claim si customer, that's 12,000, then accounts receivable assigned 600,000. Kita gapoy mag-entry ha. Kita may tag iya sa AR, kita yung mag-entry. Kita gapoy mag-entry. Yes, kita gapoy mag-entry kay again, we are still the owner of the AR. Gi-assign lang nato kang bank. Okay, so we are still the owner of the AR. That's why mo entry gihapon ta. Diba? Okay, kung di ta mag-entry, atong utang magpabilin nga 800,000. Diba? Kung di ta mag-entry, nya nagbayad naman atong customer dito sa iya. So mo na itong entry, that's why debit note payable, debit sales discount, credit AR assigned 600,000. Then, magbayad ta og interest. Diba? We need to pay for the interest. So, kani, mubayad kita kang bank. Okay, so, muna lang itong i-remit sa iya ang payment for interest. So, that's 1% of 800, that's 8,000. Oh, paabot og August. Okay, kung mag-t-account ta dire, AR assigned, 1 million atong gi-assign. Tapos, nanay na-collecta nga 600,000. So, nanay lang tayo AR assigned balance as of July, 400,000. Sa ato pong utang, pila itong utang, note payable, 800,000. Since nagbayad si customer, nalay 2% discount, 588 lang atong ang nabawas sa utang. So, as of July 31, nanalang kay utang nga 800 minus 588 of 212. Okay, on August 31, nakadawat na po tag-notice kang bank. Uy, entity, nakakolekta na po kong 300,000 sa katoy mong gi-assign. So, final settlement was made by the bank for the excess collections together with the uncollected assigned accounts of 110,000. So, naitabo, nakakolekt na po si bank or na-customer nagbayad kang bank 300,000. Question, pinanala tong utang kang bank? pinanalay balance atong utang kang bank before nato ni na-collect ni na sa August 31. Okay, pila? Dalawa itong T-account, di ba mo ni? Nanalantay utang nga 212,000. Okay, nanalantay utang nga 212,000. Pila ang na-collect ni bank? 300,000. Sinitabo, sobra ra, di ba? Sobra ra ang na-collect ni bank. Unsa itong buhaton? Siyempre, i-remit to ni bank sa ato. Uy, entity, imong utang 212 na lang pero ang gibayad diri ni customer 300,000. So sobra na siya, so akong ibalik sa imo ang balance. Okay, so unsa ni tabo? Oh, yes, maka-receive ta og cash. Okay, gikan kang bank because di ba tomantanan kang bank ang kwarta. Sobra ra ang bayad. So ang hitabo, oy, sige, 300. 300 ako na kolekta, 212 na lang mong utang. So, pila na bilin, that's 300 minus 212.88. Pero, di ba, napaka-interest na bayaran sa ako. Di ba, 1% of 212. Ibawas na lang na ako sa entity ha. Okay, para akong ihatag sa imong nga cash, limpyo na, net na. Nabawasan na sa imong utang, nabawasan na po sa imong interest. So, ang itabo, minus, pila man ni 212 times 1%, that's 2,120. So, ang net na akong ihatag sa imo entity, 88,000 minus 2,120. So, 80 na lang akong i-remit sa imo. That's why, atong entry, di ba, kadawat taog cash kang bank, 85,880. Tapos natay interest expense because naka-incur tag interest for 1 month na 212,120. Tapos ang balance sa tong utang 212. Therefore, ang tanan na collect na AR 300. Kung magti-account ta kang AR, di ba 400 man eh. Natay 1 million AR assigned. Natay 1 million na-collect ang 600 gaina, tapos karon na-collect, pila yung na-collect 300. Napatay balance itong AR. Yes, napatay balance. Money ang 100K nga nabilin. Kung sa ibuhaton na to, ani, ibalik na to, di ba, to regular nga AR. So, itong buhaton, ang entry niya, debit AR regular, credit AR assigned. Ang balance na 100K. Okay, mo niya entry, gibuhat. Okay, nagets ra ba ang notification basis and non-notification basis under assignment of AR? Okay ra ba? Sabtan ra, ang gantong equity, sir. Ah, narayang kondre, oh. O sige, let's have the equity. Diba, ang sige, ito formula sa equity, AR assigned balance minus the note payable bank balance. That's the equity assigned. Okay, based on the illustration, sa August, wala na yun, zero out na. Because zero man ang imong, na zero out naman imong AR assigned because gibalik naman na ito, kanipod, nabayaran na tanan. But here sa computation, ano ba sa'yo computation dere? Ah, sige lang. Ito'y pala yun eh. So this is the computation. So statement presentation, the entity provide the following accounts at year end. Okay, so you have 4 million unassigned. Example lang niya, presentation. Accounts receivable assigned, allowance for doubtful accounts. You have note payable, napakaibayro nun na 400. Question, pila ang total AR? So, total AR is composed of your unassigned na 4 million plus the assigned 1 million. So, part niya po siya sa imong AR, ang assigned. Tapos, minus the doubtful accounts, allowance, ADA, Then you can compute your net realizable value. So the NRV 49 is included in the caption trade and other receivables, which is the second line item. Okay, then under equity assigned, okay, based on the given kani, based on this information, okay, so you have accounts receivable 1 million balance, tapos na kay note payable bank 400,000, therefore you have equity in assigned account of 600,000. Again, dili ni siya makita sa imong financial statement because this is only disclosed in the notes to financial statement. So, ipakita is so, i-mention lang sa notes ni mo na naay na disclose or naay equity in assigned accounts of 600,000. Okay. Question. My question. Clear to ha? Kung clear siya, type 1. Kung clear, kung nasabtan ra, klaro ba? Okay, sige, let's continue. Thank you for your response. Let's answer this one. But on December 1, 2020, solvent company assigned specific accounts receivable totaling 5 million as collateral on a 4 million 12% note from a certain bank. The entity will continue to collect the assigned accounts receivable. So based on the statement, first paragraph, notification or non-notification basis? What do you think? Diba, why non-notification? Why non-notification? Okay, very good, diba? Because the entity will continue to collect, diba? Will continue to collect the assigned accounts receivable. Therefore, wala na inform si customer or non-notification basis siya because we are still the one to collect the receivable tapos kita na ang mo-remit kang bank. So, diba, nangutang ta 5 million atong gi-assign pero ang gipautang sa ato is only 4 million. Tapos na 12% interest per annum note from the bank. In addition to the interest on the note, the bank also charged a 5% finance fee deducted in advance on the assigned accounts. So, diba, aside from the interest charge, naput siya 5% nga finance fee times the assigned accounts of 5 million. So, pila ang charge ana, that's 5 million times 0.05. That's 250,000. That is, 250,000. So, sa 4 million na gipautang, nabawasan na siya 250 nga service charge. Okay, the December collections of assigned accounts receivable amounted to 2 million less cash discount of 200,000. Okay, hinahinayon na to ha. Dili sa ta sa pag-utang nato. Question, pila tong nadawat pag-utang nato? So 4 million ang ipautang sa to. Tapos gibawasan og 250 nga service charge, pila na lang atong na-receive. So 4 million minus 250,000 3,750,000 na lang ang cash nga atong na-receive. Okay, therefore, sa question number 1, what amount of cash was received from the assignment of AR on December 1, 2020? So the answer is 3,750,000. Okay, di ba? So inani ba na nag-entry ta AR assign AR 5 million. Pila ang cash nga to nadawat? We only received 3,750. Kay na ay service charge na 250. Tapos ang ipautang sa to, note payable is 4 million. Okay, that's the entries. Therefore, the answer is letter D, 3,750. Next question, what is the carrying amount of note payable on December 31, 2020? So, pila daw balance sa itong note payable on December 31, 2020? So, dirita, start na din. The December collections of assigned accounts receivable amounted to 2 million less cash discount of 200,000. Sige yun. So, entry na to aning collection. Debit, cash. Sige daw. Provide the entry for the collection. What's the correct entry for the collection? Collection of AR 2 million less cash discount. I-kompleto. Listen man, ikompleto, no? Kay mag-enter in term nito. So, debit cash, pilay amount. Okay, cash is 1,800,000 because net of discount. Debit, another debit is 200,000. Then, we credit the AR. AR assigned 2 million. Sa sakit sa mata. Sige, cash, 1,800,000, sales discount, 200, AR assigned, 2 million. Okay, that's the entry. And then, since nakakolekta, nagremita, di ba? The entity remitted the collections to the bank in payment for the interest accrued to the bank in payment for the interest accrued on December 31, 2020 and note payable. So, giremit the entity ang collections to the bank in payment for the interest accrued on December 31, 2020 and the note payable. So, atong gibayad. Note payable, interest expense. Pila tong interest expense ani? Sige daw, be, give me the interest expense. That is, pila to? 12% note from a certain bank. So that's the interest rate 12%. $40,000. Okay, how did you get the 40,000? Okay, the answer is 40,000. 12% per annum, sir. Yes, 12%, that is annual rate. Since December naman ta, so only 1 month. So 480,000 is the annual interest expense, but 1 month lang man, December 1 to December 30. So that is only 40,000. Okay, that's correct, 40,000. Yes, 4 million times 12% times 1 over 12. Yes, that's correct. Okay. How about the note payable? Okay, how about the note payable? Dili atong gibayaran, pila lang. Pila lang atong gibayaran. Okay, let's read the problem ha. Ang inya dire, the entity remitted the collections to the bank in payment for the interest accrued on December 31, 2020 and the note payable. Therefore, pila ra gyud na collect? We only collected 1,800,000. The 1,800,000 daw nga atong na collect, atong ibayad. Okay, atong ibayad for the interest accrued and the note payable. Therefore, 1/8 ra gyud atong gibayad. Apil na ang interest, apil na ang principal. So pila ra nato sa principal? So that's 1,800,000 minus the 40,000 interest. Pila lang nato sa principal? 1,760. Okay, 1,760, therefore, the cash na itong girimit is 1,800,000. So, the question now is, pila daw ang balance sa imong note payable on December 31, 2020? So, mag T-account ta, your note payable, you have beginning balance of 4 million. Tapos nakabayad ta og 1,760, pila'y balance. That's 4 million minus 1,760. Okay, that is 2,240,000. Okay, bantayan ninyo ha, kaya ang pagka-state sa problem, ang girimit ra daw nato ang collections as payment for the interest plus the note payable. Kagayin na sa problem, girimit na to pangbayad sa principal plus nagdugang for interest. So kanima ang gistate sa problem, the entity remitted the collections to the bank in payment for the interest accrued and the note payable. So 1/8 lang gid ang atong girimit. Okay, kay kung mag-add ta, di ba ang answer pwede letter D. Kung mag 1/8 ta dire tapos plus 40 tapos atong gibayad is 1,840. But based on the statement, girimit lang daw na to ang collections in payment for the interest og sa note payable. Okay, number 3, what amount should be disclosed as the equity of solvent company in assigned accounts? So, sagay formula ani, AR assigned balance, tapos note payable balance. So, you have note payable balance. Pilin na bilin sa itong AR assigned. Yeah, beginning, pila to itong assigned? 5 million. Tapos, nakakolekta o 2 million lang. So, that's 3 million balance. Minus the note na to na 2,240. So the answer is 760,000. Okay, 30. Okay, ana lang, di ba? So, medyo di kayo sa complicated. Paabot sa assignment. Okay, before we proceed with the third type of receivable financing, any questions for pledge and assignment? I hope clear, ha? I hope it's clear. Masabtan siya. So, let's proceed with the third type of receivable financing. You have the factoring. So, under factoring, this is sale of AR on a without recourse notification basis. Kagaina si pledge and assignment, diba ato lang gi-collateral ang atong AR. Therefore, since gi-collateral ra nato sa gi-pledge, gi-assign lang nato siya, we are still the owner of the AR. But this time under factoring, ato nang gibaligya ang AR. So ato nang gibaligya ang AR. On a without recourse basis, what do you mean by without recourse? Ipasa ang responsibility sa PICAS party. So, without recourse, di ba, gibaligyan na nato, kita ne. Gibaligyan na to, natay AR kang customer, kita si entity, atong gibaligya kang buyer. Okay, gibaligyan nato. When you say without recourse, once nabaligyan na nato ang AR dito, wala na tayo liability. Diba? Wala tayo liability kang buyer in case dili mo bayad si customer sa iya. Because sale naman siya, diba? So when you say sale, na-transfer na ang ownership. So, si B na ang tag-iya sa AR in which siya na mo collect kang C. Diba? Siya na mo collect kang C. So, kung si C dili mo bayad kang B, wala na tayo problema ato. Ano man, without recourse man siya. So, wala tayo liability. In case dili mo bayad si C kang B. So, without recourse, wala tayo liability. So, dili ta liable to pay if mo dishonor or dili mo bayad si C kang B. Notification basis po siya. So, dapat nahibalo si customer. Of course, dapat pahibawon si customer. Kaya kung dili kabalo si customer, mubayad sa ato, hindi naman kita ang owner sa AR. So that's why under factoring, without recourse siya, notification basis. Para since na-transfer na ang ownership sa AR, si customer, diretso na mubayad dito. Kang B. Eh si B naman ang tag-iya. Dili na kita as entity. So atong gibaligya para magkasta. Para mabayaran ng atong mga currently maturing obligations. So again, there is a transfer of ownership of the accounts receivable to the factor. Therefore, kani si B gitawag di sa as factor. Kato atong gibaligyaan si buyer. Okay, so under factoring, you have casual factoring, so casual sale. Okay, direct recognition. So, natay two types. You have casual factoring and continuing agreement. Okay, so under casual sale, direct recognition of gain or loss. Since it's a sale transaction, pwede ito magka-gain, pwede ito magka-loss. Diba, what if ang value or ang net realizable value sa imong AR 100,000, gibaligya lang ni mo o 90,000, so gansi ta, loss ta. Diba? So, under casual factoring, normally it's a normal sale transaction lang siya. Okay, so let's say for example, casual ta ha, it's a casual sale. So, natay AR na 150,000, tapos naay ada niya na 50,000. Therefore, iyang NRV is 100,000. So, ato ning gibaligya. Gibaligya nato ni kang factor kita man si E. Pilay baligya na to ani, let's say 95,000 lang. Ginan sa talugi. Ginan sa talugi. Okay, di ba? Lugi ta. Because ang value sa atong receivable 100, gibaligya lang nato 95. So, sa atong entry ani, nakadawat ta og cash, 95,000. Atong gibaligya ang AR, so atong i-close ang ADA, that's 50,000. Si AR, 150,000. So, gan si taog, loss on factoring of 5,000. Okay, normally magka-loss gyud ta ngano man because kita may nanginahan og kwarta, di ba? So kung unaon ninyo ba, kinahanglan nato og kwarta, ibaligya namo ang AR, mosugot gyud ta nga paliton sa ata lower price because I need ta og money. At so usually in factoring or sale of AR, magka-loss gyud ta. Because di ba, nanginahanglan ta og kwarta. So bahala na, bahala gamay ang atong palit kay kinanglan ako para makabayad ko sa utang. So, normally, musugot yun ang mga inana nga cases. So, that's casual factoring. Under factoring as a continuing agreement, so, may involve a continuing arrangement where a finance entity purchases all of the accounts receivable of a certain entity. So, in this setup, before a merchandise is shipped to a customer, the selling entity requests the factor's credit approval. So, under continuing agreement, di ba, nakik-agree na ta kang factor, kang bank. So, every time, murag ang goods na pa sa ato, ang AR na pa sa ato. So, every time na, let's say for example, there's merchandise to be shipped to the selling entity, so, kinalan pa ta mag approval to the factor. So, mura na yung agreement ba between us, the entity, and the factor. Okay, so under continuing agreement, natay items to be considered. So, you have the gross amount of AR factored, morning AR nga atong gibaligya. Tapos, si factor normally, mukuha na sa og commission, mucharge sa og interest, mucharge sa og service charge, tapos na sa factors holdback. What do you mean by factors holdback? So basically, gross amount sa tong AR minus the commission, minus the interest, minus the service charge, minus the factors holdback, muna na tong loss. Diba? Lugi na taan na. Dili ingon lugi. Muna ang balance sa cash nga ito na-receive from factoring. Okay, so deduct na ng commission, interest, bank service charge, then that's the net proceeds from the sale of our AR. What do you mean by factors hold back? So, factors hold back, predetermined amount by withhold by the factor as a protection against customer returns and allowances and other special adjustments. The factors hold back is a receivable account and classified as current asset. So, yan yung mitabo, factors hold back, di ba? Kita si entity, gibaligyan na to kang bank or kang factor. Siyempre, si factor, manigurado. Since ako naman yung paliton ng imong receivable, basin part anang receivable nimo na ay discount si customer, sales discount, na ay iuli si customer, na ay doubtful for collection. So, unsa akong buhaton as factor? So, manigurado ko, mukuha ko og factors holdback, mukuha ko og certain percentage sa imong gibaligya sa ako nga AR, nga kanisiya, it's a security on my part in case na I return, in case na I allowances for uncollectability, in case na I discount, diri na ko kaon sa akong gi-withhold yung factors holdback. Okay, kumbaga, kanasiya, mura sa security sa part ni factor na if dili pa makolekta tanan, prone pa ang AR because di ba siya na may owner sa AR. If dili pa niya makolekta nan, prone siya ngan basin na ay i-return, basin na ay i-discount, basin na ay doubtful for collection. So siya, aha man ako kaon, magansi ko. Kung dili ko mag-set aside og amount na pangbayad ani sa ila. That's why nasa factors holdback. Kung bagagi, withhold ni factor, ni bank, or the financial institution, in case na ay return, in case na ay discount, in case na ay doubtful for collection. But unsa man isiha, this is considered as receivable account and classified as current account. So, kanang factors holdback, dawatuno na to na kang factor kang bank. Kay in case na-collecta na tanan, walay discount, walay return, walay nag-claim o discount, walay nag-uli, tapos walay doubtful for collection, pwede na ito isabawion sa iya. Anong factors hold back? So, it's a receivable on our part and classified as current asset. Okay. So, ako lang i-correct ka, dapat diril lang ni Taman. Walay labot ang factors hold back because factors hold back is a receivable account. So, under continuing agreement, the commission, interest, and bank service charge, normally that is the loss on factoring. Siyempre, di ba? 1 million atong gibaligya, pero gikawan og commission, gikawan og interest, gikawan og service charge, so lugi na ta ato. Di ba? That's loss on factoring. The factors hold back, dili sa considered as loss because it's a receivable account. So, dawatunon na to ni Kang factor in case walay claims for returns, walay claims for discount. Okay, klaro ba? Klaro ang factoring ha? So, factoring is a sale. Ibaligya na to ang AR, therefore, na-transfer na ang ownership sa AR. So, si factor na, ibaligya na to kang factor, so, si factor na ang naay right sa AR, naay ownership sa AR, therefore, sana po yung mangolekta. Di na kita, because wala naman ta. But on the part of the factor lang, naasay mga charges, gina-charge for the sale of AR. So, you have the commission, you have the interest, you have the bank service charge. At the same time, nasa'y gina-withhold, which is the factors hold back, si factor, para in case na ay returns, na ay discount, and doubtful for collection, protected siya. But this is a receivable on our part. What if wala, na-collectanan, tapos pwede na ito nibawion sa iya ang factors hold back niya, ang gina-withhold niya amount. Okay, illustration presented in the book. So, the entity factored accounts receivable of 500,000 with credit terms 210 and 30 immediately after shipment of the goods to the customer. So, naitaboan ni kita, atong gifactor atong AR nga 500,000 with credit terms of 210 and 30. Diba? Kung tanaw ni mo, gibaligyan nato ni 500 pero pwede pa na i-claim nga discount 2 over 10. Pero dili na kita ang tag-iyaan eh. Diba? So, si factor na because nabaligya na. Ito ang gibaligya. So, the factor charge a 5% commission based on the gross amount of the receivable factored. In addition, the factor withheld 20% of the amount of the receivable factored to cover sales returns and allowances. So, therefore, kaning 20% yung gwidol, manay gitawag na ito nga factors hold back. Okay, di ba? Mauna itong gross amount, 500. Ayang gigamit diri, naka-net method siya. Iyan ang gididakdaan ng sales discount. Siyempre, nanigurado si factor. Di ba? Kay naghatag pa yung 2% discount, tapos ako na raba ang owner ani because na-transfer na siya. So, sa part sa computation, gididak na daan si sales discount. So, naka-net method siya. Regardless kung gikuha ba or wala. So, 2% times 500, that's 10,000. Then, the commission is 5%, then factors holdback is 20%. So, From 500, na ay total kaltas na 135, muna nilin itong nadawat nga cash, 365. So, if the customer is subsequently allowed a credit of 50,000 for the damaged merchandise, okay, the journal entry is, so what if na ay gi-return 50,000 cost of merchandise? So, unsay may tabo? So, syempre, sales, returns, and allowances, 50,000. Ano to ibawas? Dito sa gi-withhold. Di ba, pila tanang yung gi-withhold? 100,000. Enough ba ang gi-withhold? Yes, enough ang gi-withhold. Sir, nga nung sa entry, sir, na may sales discount nila nga 2% times 50,000. Ama na, gikat. Di ba, kagaina, gi-assume sa computation, gibawas niya ang discount. Diba, nag-net method siya. So, that's 2% times 500,000. So, ang assumption ani, mukuha og discount, tanan 500,000, 2%. Pero, nahitabo, naigiuli nga 50,000. Therefore, dili na to siya makatake sa discount because giuli na siya. So, that's why, gibawasan niya ang sales discount og 2%. So, that's 50,000 times 2%, 1,000. Diba? So, supposedly, dapat dili na 500 atong ibot times dira. Dapat 450 na lang. Because mo na lang ni ang eligible for discount. Because gi-return ang 50. So, kung times na to na, 450 times 2%. So, 9,000 dapat ang imong sales discount. So, 10,000 minus 1,000 o 9,000 ang net. Then, ang gibawas sa receivable from factor is only 49,000. Kaya di ba, gi-charge una sa discount. Then, when all the receivables factored are collected by the factor with no further returns and allowances, the final settlement with the factor is recorded as follows. So, therefore, na-collect na tanan, wala na returns, wala na allowances, di ba na siya gi-withhold sa ato si factor nga 100,000. Pila rin na gamit? Only 49,000. Therefore, naatay dawatunon sa iya nga 51,000. So, ato na siyang gi-receive dire. So, cash, receivable from factor, or factor's holdback, pwede rapod na siya, 51,000. So, nabalik sa ato. Question. What if mas dako ang returns kaysa factor's holdback? So, gansi na si factor ana. Wala na, hurot na. Hurot na ang na-exhaust na tanan iyang gi-reserve for returns. Wala na po tayo dawatunon sa iya because, di ba, nahurot na. Na-consume siya. What if mas dako ang returns kaysa factor's holdback? Ang difference ana, it's a loss na ni factor. So, gansi na siya ato si factor. Kita, wala na tayo obligation. Wala tayo obligation to pay the balance. Because, again, without recourse siya. So, dili ta liable. Di ta liable if pagsubra na ang returns kaysa sa iyang gi-withhold. Okay, sige. Other questions na pa? Oh, kani, another illustration. Gi-factor na to 3 million. Control was surrendered pasabot, na-transfer na ang ownership. The factor accepted the accounts receivable subject to oh, kani lahi pud siya. So problem gi-state dire, gi-accept ni factor ang AR subject to recourse for non-payment. So, ang nahitabo dire sa problem, ang ilang agreement, sige, paliton na ako na. Pero, with recourse ta. Pasabot sa with recourse, pag dili mo bayad ang customer, liable ta to pay to the factor. Okay, so that's for non-payment. If dili mo bayad si customer, so kinalanta mo bayad kang factor. kani sigurista si factor. So the fair value of the recourse obligation is 100,000. So in case dili makabayad for non-payment, money ang atong obligation, bayad ta og 100,000. The factors assess a fee of 6% and retain a holdback equal to 10% of the accounts receivable. So naay 6% nga service fee tapos naay factors holdback nga 10%. In addition, the factor charged 12% interest computed on a weighted average time to maturity of 50 days. So 12% interest pero 50 days lang ang iyang gi-count. Bantayin ninyo niya, pag ang problem mo ingon og weighted average time use 365 days. Bali 1 year is equal to 365 days. Pero kung mingon na sa wala sa nag-mention og weighted average time, the assumption is 1 year is equal to 360 days. So again, pag weighted average time, 1 year is equal to 365 days. Pero kung wala sa nag-mention ng weighted average time, 1 year is equal to 360 days. Sir, what if silent? If silent ang problem, use 360 days. Okay, so based on the problem, you have AR 3 million imong gibaligya, gifactor. You have the holdback of 10%. You have 6% factoring fee or service charge. You have interest of 3 million times 12% times 50 days divide 365 days because naka-weighted average time siya. Therefore, these are the total deductions from your gross amount of your AR factored. So, ang cash mo na-receive is only 2,470,685. The loss on factoring initially recognized. Diba? So, pila imong loss, pila imong lugi. So again, walay appeal si factors holdback because that's a receivable account. So imo lang lugi is si factoring fee nga 180, si interest nga 49,315 plus the recourse obligation. Okay, that's loss on factoring initially recognized. So included si loss recourse obligation because if dili mo bayad si client, si customer, you are liable to that certain amount, 100,000. So, giapil siya. So, note that recourse obligation is initially recorded as a loss on factoring. Pero wala sa gi-minus sa 3 million ni mga AR factored. Okay, so again, but it is included, it is considered as part of the loss on factoring initially recognized. Okay, to record the factoring, cash, this is the amount received. You have due from factor, this is the factor's holdback, factoring fee, you have interest expense, you have loss, diba, on recourse obligation, 100,000, you have accounts receivable, 3 million, and you have the recourse liability of 100,000. To reverse the recourse liability, assuming the accounts are fully collected by the factor, ito lang siyang gi-reverse. Diba, since we will incur this loss or liability once non-payment, dili magbayad si customer kang factor. But if assuming the accounts are fully collected by the factor, so we are not liable for this 100,000. So ito lang siyang gi-reverse. That's why, ang yang gi-mention dere, initially recognized loss. Diba? Initially recognized loss. So, manang gi-appeal siya. Okay, this means, okay, if this is the case, na-collect tanan, we reverse the recourse liability, then this means that the net loss from factoring is 3,295 minus 100,000. So, 229,315 na lang siya. Diba? Because initially, na-appeal ni mo, pero if na-collectanan by the factor, i-deduct na to siya. So, 229,315 na lang atong loss on loss from factoring. Okay, to collect the factor's holdback, if sobra gid siya, then we can collect the excess of the factor's holdback. So assuming the accounts are not collected by the factor, so what if wala na collect? Siyempre, we are liable. So tarawan, sinitabo, di ba, nagbayad ta because wala nakabayad si customer, non-payment of the customer. So recourse liability, we pay for cash at 100,000. So same lang, collect factor's holdback. Then two entries can be compounded o pwede rin yung i-compound, di ba, i-accumulate ang cash. Okay, so actually same entry lang na siya, nakatinamban lang ning nasa taas. Question so far. Question. Clear na ba? Sige daw, if clear, type 1. Okay, I hope clear good sa ha. Okay, sige, let's answer this one. This is a factoring problem. Sige lang, give me answer for number one question first. Okay, Zeus Company factored 6 million of AR to a finance entity at the beginning of the current year. Control was surrendered by Zeus Company. The factor accepted the accounts receivable subject to recourse for non-payment. So therefore, di ba, with recourse gapon siya, so in case dili mo bayad, liable ta to pay 100,000. The factor assessed a fee of 3% and retained a holdback equal to 5% of the accounts receivable. In addition, there's a charge of 15% interest computed on a weighted average time to maturity of the accounts receivable of 54 days. First question, what is the amount of cash initially received from the factoring? Sige daw, pila. Try to compute. Nanay answer. Okay, what's your answer for question number one? Cash initially received from the factoring. Okay, sige. Tana? Okay. Sige, let's try. Most of the answers. How about the others? Okay, let's check if your answers are correct. So most of the answers, and you answered letter B. Okay, let's check. You have 6 million. Tapos you have commission, you have factor's fee of 3%. So that's 6 million times 3%. So that is 180. So minus 180,000. Next is you have factor's holdback of 5%. So that's 6 million times 5%. So that is 300,000. So factors hold back, so 300,000. Tapos na interest na 15%. Again, weighted average time 54 days, so that's 6 million times 15% times 54 days divide 365. So that's 6 million times 15% times 54 days divide 365. So that is 133. Okay, sige, let's say 150. So this is the interest. 133,150. So 6 million minus 180 minus 300 minus 133,150. So the cash received is 5,386,850. That is letter B. Okay, so your answer is correct. So 5,386,850. Next, if all accounts are collected, what is the loss on factoring of the accounts receivable? If all accounts daw are collected, pila ang loss on factoring? Sige daw. Pilang loss on factoring if makolekta tanan? Okay, the answer is letter A. Since makolekta sa tanan, so wala tay liability, di ba? Wala tay recourse liability ng 100,000. Therefore, our loss is the factor's fee of 180,000 and the interest of 133,150, that is 313,150. Okay, number 3. If all accounts are not collected, what is the loss on factoring? So just add the 100, di ba? So 313,150. Add lang nato ang recourse liability of 100,000. So that's 413,150. So letter C. Okay, so di ba? I guess no nagsabtan na ninyo. Because your answers are correct man for the problem. So, I assume na okay dataan eh, factoring. Okay. So, we are done with factoring. So, let's proceed with the last. Okay, continue na lang ta para maka-end po taog sa'yo. So, let's proceed. Ah, okay, so napaday other concept dere nga gibutang is you have credit card concept. Ingon sila dere, credit card is applies the concept of factoring. Diba? Applies the concept of factoring. So, ano itabo sa credit card, diba? Si BDO naghatag sa og card kang customer. Tapos si customer nipalit kang Gaysano gamit iyang credit card. Da grocery si customer gamit ang credit card. So kita Kinsa ta nga perspective diri, we are in the perspective of Gaisano. Nakita si Gaisano diri. Okay, nipalit si customer sa ato, ang iyang gigamit, credit card iyang gibayad. Diba? Credit card iyang gibayad. So, kita ang nai-receivable kang BDO. Okay, si BDO man ang mubayad ana sa ato. Diba? Si BDO man ang mubayad ana sa ato. Kay pag swipe ni customer, diba? Si BDO, kita mangolekta kang BDO. Si BDO pod, mukolekta siya kang customer, diba? So, mo na yung mahitabo sa credit card nga transaction. Si customer, wala na naikuan sa ato. Kaya kang BDO na siya mubayad. Diba? Sa iyang giutang. So, kita si Gaisano, okay, some sort of factoring siya, nga naman, question ako, diba? In this transaction, kita si Gaisano, mas dako ba itong ma-receive kang, let's say for example, nangutang si customer 10,000 worth of groceries iyang giswipe. Diba? Sa ato. Gaisano. Tapos nangolekta ta kang BDO. Question na ako karon. Kita si Gaisano, pila ka atong madawat kang BDO? Higher sa 10,000 or lower sa 10,000? What do you think? Diba? I-throw na ako ha. Si customer, nasa credit card ni BDO. Tapos, si customer nag-grocery sa ato. Kita si Gaisano. We are in the perspective of Gaisano. Kita si Gaisano, nag-grocery sa kang Gaisano. Worth 10,000 grocery, iyang gigamit iyang credit card. So, kita, di ba wala tayo cash na dawat? Kaso, kinsa na ito, kolektahon ang katong 10,000. So, kita ang mo collect anak ang BDO. Or si BDO mo bayad sa ato. So, pwede, the other way around. Tapos, si customer, mubayad kang BDO or si BDO, mangolekta sa kang customer. Si customer, dili na mubalik dito sa ato para magbayad. Diba, bangko naman ta magbayad if naggamit ta sa credit card. Akong question karon, pag mangolekta ta kang BDO, pila atong makolekta kang BDO? Higher ba sa 10,000 or lower sa 10,000? Okay, the correct answer is lower. Lower siya because naay service charge. Diba, murag sa actually ako at first ako nauna dapat dako ang ibayad di BDO because diba tungod kang Gaisano nakakuan si BDO, diba kumbaga nagamit ang card ni customer tungod kang Gaisano kay mo dawat sa credit card. Pero ang tubag day ana is baliktad siya. Ang ibayad ni BDO lower than 10,000 because of service charge. Why? Ang reason, kung walay credit card si customer, dili mo mahalinan og 10,000. Mag-aana ba? Kung walay credit card si customer, di mo mahalinan og 10,000. So, because of our credit card, paspas inyong sales. So, pag manukot mo sa amo, nagid may service charge nga i-charge. So, therefore, ang iyang ihatag dito, lower than 10,000. Let's say, for example, na 5% nga service charge, so that's 9,500 na lang atong madawat as Gaisano gikan kang BDO. Diba, some sort of factoring. Mura atong gibaligya ang AR nato kang BDO, tapos lower ang amount nga ginahatag ni BDO sa ato. So, entry, pag nakadawat na ta, cash, o service charge, sales siya. So, lower siya. So, mura sa gitawag po og factoring because of this koan. Na ang madawat ni Gaisano is lower than the amount na katong giswipe ni customer. Because si BDO mo charge siya or si bank or financial institution mag-charge siya og service charge. Okay. So, let's continue with the last type of receivable financing. This time, dili na AR atong gigamit. Di ba kagaina, under factoring, under pledge, under assignment, we use the AR. This time, under discounting, we discount the note receivable. Okay, we discount the note receivable. Since note receivable siya, di ba naatay promissory note, gikan kang customer. Di ba naatay promissory note, gikan kang customer. So, katong promissory note, mo to itong gamiton para magka-cash ta. So, in what way? Di ba? Through discounting. Through discounting. So, unsay may tabo sa discounting? Si maker, si customer, naghatag sa og promissory note sa ato. So, kita si payee. Diba? Kita si payee. Because, kita man ang mag-receive og payment. Since naglisod ta, nag-struggle ta to pay our currently maturing obligations, so, sa itong kinalan buhaton para maka-generate tag cash. So, ang gibuhat ni payee, iyang gi-endorse ang note kang bank. That's why nahimo sang endorser because iyang gi-endorse or by signing the note iyang gi-endorse ang note to the bank. Tapos si bank nahimo sang endorsee. Okay. So medyo kuti ang discounting on note receivable because dahan sang formulas to consider. For once you have familiarized the formulas, once you have understand the concept, dili na sa ina na kalisod. Okay, so okay, mo na may tabo sa discounting of your note receivable. So murag ang naitabo, imong gipa-discount sa bank, imong gipa-ilisdan sa bank ang note receivable ni mo gikan kang customer para magka-cash ka. Okay, so kinahanglan nimo og endorsement. So under discounting of note receivable, so naatay two types of endorsement. You have the without recourse basis and you have the with recourse basis. Diba? Na-mention na gaina, when you say recourse, pag without recourse, wala tay liability. So ang nitabuan ni Mang Gyud is mura gyapon atong gibaligya ang atong note receivable kang bank. Kaya gipailisdan naman nato ang note receivable nato, gi-endorse nato kang bank. So kung mingkag without recourse, endorsers avoids future liability even if the maker refuses to pay the endorsee on the date of maturity. Therefore, there's no secondary liability. So in case si maker dili mo bayad kang bank on the date of maturity, since without recourse, wala tayo liability to pay if mo dili mo bayad si maker. But if it is with recourse basis, endorser shall pay. Kita si endorser ha, we are the payee. We are on the perspective of the payee and endorser. Endorser shall pay the endorsee if the maker dishonors the note. So in case dili mo bayad si maker on maturity date, we are liable to pay to the bank or to the endorsee because with recourse ang atong agreement. Ang endorsement is with recourse. So, endorser has a secondary liability. Therefore, secondary liable ta if with recourse. But if without recourse, we have no secondary liability. Magkaunsa-unsa, wala tayo labot pag without recourse. Okay, these are the terms that you need to consider under discounting. Okay, net proceeds, ani man ni pwede man ani may tabo sa discounting, 'di ba? Nakadawat ta karon, let's say nakadawat ta karon January 1 og note gikan kang customer. Tapos ang terms ana niya, let's say 9 months. 9 months ang terms ana niya. Nagulat-hulat ta. Kabasin day 9 months ang term, basin day mo bayad jag sayo-sayo. Oh, latulat ta. O, nilabay ang 3 months, January, February, March, niabot og April 1. Let's say, ano na lang sa, para clear ang illustration. Diba, January 1, naghatag 9 months to pay, kanos ang manataman, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, September, that's September 30. kay 9 months man siya nga note. Oh, so what if pag-abot og April 1, wa na tay kwarta, naglisod na ta. Tapos na tay bayro nun. Diba? Na ay currently maturing obligations or kinalan sa operation. So, wala tayo lain choice para magkakwarta ta, we need to find ways para magkakash ta. So, atong gibuhat, katong note nga itong nakuha kang customer from January 1, dated January 1, ato itong gipa-discount. Atong gipa-ilisdan kang bank para makakwarta ta. Okay, ang question karon, pila, oh, let's say for example, ang amount ani 100,000, kung atong ipa-discount on April 1, pila ka months ang nilabay ana, that's 3 months ang nilabay, di ba? Okay, from the whole 9 months na iyang term. So, 100,000, so ang question ana karon, pag atong ipa-discount on April 1, pila ka atong madawat sa bank? So obviously, dili gud na 100,000 because again, di ba, nanginangalan ta, so normally, ubos gud na atong madawat nga net proceeds na to. Kaya na yung mga charges. Okay, so muna ang question karon, pila ang proceeds nga atong madawat if ato siyang ipa-discount on April 1? Okay, so that's why we need to understand these terms. Net proceeds, when you say net proceeds, muna ang cash nga atong nadawat from discounting. Diba, mo ng cash nga itong na-receive from discounting of our note receivable. So, how do we compute net proceeds? You have maturity value minus discount. What do you mean by maturity value, sir? Maturity value, that is principal plus interest. I know you know how to compute that one. Since natay receivable. So, principal plus interest. How about the discount? How do we compute the discount? So, discount is computed maturity value times the discount rate times the discount period. Okay, times the discount period. Then, divide 360 or 365 days depending on the problem. Yun sa pag-mention. So, the discount period, sir, unsa man ang discount period? The discount period is the unexpired term. So, based on our illustration kagaina, di ba 9 months ang note? After 3 months, imong gi-discount. Therefore, your discount period or the unexpired term is starting April 1 to September 30. Pila na ka months? That's 6 months. So, mo na yung gamiton pag-discount. Discount period nimo using the discount rate times the maturity value. Okay, gain or loss on discounting. How do we compute gain or loss on discounting? So, naagap mo tayo gain or loss dire because mura sa factoring gihapon na lugi ta. Pwede ta malugi, pwede ta maginansa, but most likely, lugi yun ta. So, how to compute? You have the net proceeds, you have the carrying amount of note. Diba, kung ano ninyo ang formula, connected na sila tanan. Diba, so net proceeds na nag-una, maturity value. So, ang pag-compute ang maturity value, naana ta. Ang discount, appeal gapon si maturity value. Okay, gain or loss, naa si net proceeds, carrying amount of note, how do we compute the carrying amount of the note? So, that's principal plus interest earned or the interest income. So, in the principal plus the interest earned, pasabot katunang na-receive na nato or considered earned na nato or considered as income na siya. Yes, accumulated. Okay. So, kung tanawin nimo sa itong illustration kagaina, pila ka months earned after siya gi-discount? Okay. That is 3 months, di ba? Kay January 1, gi-discount na to April 1, so naka-income na tag-interest ana for 3 months. So, 3 months na itong gamiton dire. Principal plus interest earned for 3 months. Okay, then interest earned, oh, this is the interest earned, principal times nominal rate times the expired. Therefore, the January 1 to April 1 months, those are considered as the expired term. Diba, nilabay na, na-expire na. That's why interest earned na siya. And katong from discounting to maturity date niya, which is 6 months, that is considered as unexpired. Which is gamiton sa pag-compute sa discount. Okay. Okay. So, again, we have two types of endorsement. You have without recourse and with recourse. So, under with recourse, we have napute duha ka, si tawag ani, murag way. Under with recourse. How do we account discounting of notes receivable if with recourse siya? So, you have conditional sale and you have secured borrowing. So, what's the difference between the two? So, basically, ang difference lang nila is the entries. How do we account for the entries? So, conditional sale. Ito yung definition dali about conditional sale. Sige, basta kay money siya, conditional sale and secured borrowing. So, under conditional sale, so, this is discounting of note receivable. Money yung entry. So, you debit cash, you credit, you debit loss on discounting. If there is loss, then you use the note receivable discounted account. Okay, notes receivable discounted account. Then, interest income. Okay, cash is equal to the net proceeds sa taas. Loss, di ba? Natin formula ligto sa loss. Net proceeds minus the carrying amount. Note receivable discounted. This is the NR note receivable ngayon mong gibaligya. Interest income, this is the interest earned. Okay, once you have computed all the amounts sa formula, dali na lang siya i-plot sa entry. Okay, tanawin ninyo ang difference. Under secured borrowing, di ba secured borrowing siya, so nag-record ta og liability. So, we record a liability under discounting of note receivable. Aside that, we are recording a liability account, di ba liability for, di ba kanang ipang red na kung ano ang difference nila. So, under secured borrowing, there is no loss or gain on discounting. Or there is no loss on discounting. Kung sa'yo, nasa secured borrowing. So, instead of using loss on discounting, we record interest expense. Okay, basin ang pangutana, how much is the loss on discounting using secured borrowing? The answer is zero. Why? Because walay loss sa secured borrowing. Interest expense atong gigamit. And under secured borrowing, we record a liability account. Liability for note receivable discounted. Okay, di ba lahi ang account atong gigamit. Pero same na nag-amounts dira ha. And ang account titles lang nagigamit ang lahi. Second transaction is note paid by bank by the maker on maturity. So, what if nagbayad si maker on maturity date? Because this is with recourse basis, di ba? This is with recourse basis. So, syempre, note receivable discounted, kitanggal na to siya, i-remove po na to ang note receivable na original. Okay, so, di ba? So, since nabayaran na siya, so, i-remove ang discounted, ato pong gi-zero out ang note receivable. While under secured borrowing, so, nagamit ta og lahi nga account. So, liability for note receivable discounted and note receivable. Okay, what if note is dishonored by maker? Diba? Wala gibayaran. Dishonored by the maker. Wala gibayaran ni maker. Siyempre, since with recourse siya, we have the liability. So, payment to endorsee. So, kita ang nagbayad. So, unsa tong entry under conditional sale. So, same lang, accounts receivable, cash, accounts receivable, cash. kay, di ba? Kagi this owner naman eh. So, since this owner siya, so, mo na itong entry. So, wala difference between the two. Then, next is cancel the contingent liability. So, what if we cancel the contingent liability? So, ato nang gi-remove ang liability account niya. So, we debit the NR. Actually, same ra dire, oh. Diba? NR discounted and note receivable. Then, lahi na po ng account i-gamit sa PICA, secured borrowing. So, the difference is there is gain or loss on discounting under conditional sale. The note receivable discounted account, okay, there is gain or loss on discounting. The note receivable discounted account is deducted from the total notes receivable with disclosure of the contingent liability. So, pasabot, si note receivable discounted account is deducted to your total notes receivable account. Okay, tapos with disclosure of contingent liability. While under secured borrowing, the note receivable is not derecognized. Diba, wala ta nag-derecognize. Kumbaga, wala na to giminus ng atong note receivable. Unlike dire, because of this note receivable discounted account, diba, it's a deduction to your total note receivable. Under secured borrowing, the note receivable is not derecognized, but instead, an accounting liability is recorded at an equal to the face amount of note receivable discounted. That's why, atong credit dire, liability for note receivable discounted. So, this I deduct sa imong note receivable, but it is recorded as a liability account. So, manehong giyon kagaina, under secured borrowing, no gain or loss on discounting. It is charged to interest expense account. Okay, let's proceed with the illustration provided by the book. So, first is without recourse. So, 1,180,000 day, 12% note dated July 1 was received from a customer and discounted without recourse on August 30. So, naka-receive ta kang customer on July 1. During ta dire. Tapos 180 day man siya nga note, so that's pila na 6 months man ano, 180 divided 30 days, that's 6 months, so July, August, September, October, November, December. So that's December 31 iyang maturity. 12% note, so 1 million 12% note. Okay, tapos gi-discount siya on August 30. Diba? So let's say July, August. This is August 30. So dili sa gi-discount. So pila ka months or days ang stock ani, ang unexpired, diba? This is the unexpired portion. So, August, September, October, November, December. That's 120. Okay, 120 days. While the expired portion from July 1 to August 30, that is 60 days. Okay. So, maturity value, which is equal to principal plus interest, diba? To compute for the maturity, to compute for the net proceeds, diba, that's maturity value minus the discount. So, before we can compute the net proceeds, let's compute first the maturity value and the discount. So, maturity value, that's principal times, based on the formula, principal times interest, interest for the whole term of the note, diba? So, 1 million times 12%. Times 180 divide 360, so that's 60,000. Therefore, the maturity value is 1,060,000. Okay. Next is, after we compute the maturity value, let's compute for the discount. Observe that the interest must be for the full term. to compute the maturity value of the note in determining the maturity value. Discount, which is equal to the maturity value times discount rate times discount period. Diba? To compute the discount, maturity value, 1,060,000 times 15% discount rate. Bantay ninyo doon na ka-rate. Times days discount period, which is the unexpired portion, so 120, di ba? So 120 divide 360. Di ba 360 ang gigamit because wala gingon dira o weighted average. Di ba? So silent 360 siya. Therefore, the discount is 53. So, to compute for the net proceeds, you have maturity value 1,060,000 minus a discount of 53,000. Therefore, we have a net proceeds of 1,007,000. After computing the net proceeds, let's now compute the carrying amount of the note receivable. So, the formula, you have the principal plus the interest earned, the accrued interest receivable, or the interest earned, diba? Based on the formula, so that is principal, 1 million, accrued interest receivable or accrued interest earned, that's 1 million times 12% times the expired portion. Divide 360, therefore, this is the interest earned, the total carrying amount of your note receivable is 1,020,000. So, since natay net proceeds, natay carrying amount, di ba, based on the formula above, di ba, natay net proceeds, natay carrying amount, then we can now compute the gain or loss on discounting. So, to compute the gain or loss on discounting, siyempre, net proceeds, moneto na dawat nga cash, pilay value sa atong note receivable nga give pa discount, 1,020,000. Therefore, lugi ta og 13,000. Okay, so that's the difference between the net proceeds and the loss and the carrying amount of the note receivable. So, entry, journal entry. Diba? Since this is without recourse basis, so pwede ra na katong normal risa nga entries. So, you have cash, this is the net proceeds, di ba, 1,007,000 to, loss on discounting, 13,000. Yang gigamit, tanawa, pag without recourse, note receivable ra. Di ba, note receivable lang yang gigamit. Wala ka tong discounted na word. Because under with recourse to siya, kani without recourse. So, 1,000,000, then you have the interest income earned for 60 days, 20,000. Take note that the note receivable is credited directly because the sale of the note receivable is without recourse or absolute. Therefore, we don't have the liability or the secondary liability. And the interest income is credited for actual interest earned on the date of discounting. So, ano lang? Diba? So, once you have familiarized the formula, dali na lang siya to prepare the entries. What if discounting with recourse? So, depende conditional sale ba siya or secured borrowing. So, let's just answer the problem. So, 2,400,000 pesos, 6 months. So, February 1, 6 months daw. So, February, January, March, April, May, June 30. Discounted by First Bank on March 1. So, pila ka months ang nilabay? 1 month lang, di ba? So, March 1, siya gi-discount. So, this is 1 month. This is 5 months. So, 5 months ang unexpired, 1 month ang expired. To compute for the maturity value, you have principal 2,400,000 times the interest for the whole 6 months. That's 2,400,000 times 12% times 6 over. Take note ha, kaninga rate ang gamiton, the implied rate or the stated rate of the note payable, 12%, to compute for the interest. So 144, you have maturity value of 2544. To get the discount formula, maturity value times discount rate times discount period, which is the unexpired 5 months divide 12 months. Minus, then you have the net proceeds. Okay, since the term of the note is expressed in months, the counting is by months regardless of the number of days in a month. So, you have now your net proceeds. Then, this time, we compute for the carrying amount of the note. So, you have principal, pilang accrued interest earned, that's principal times interest rate times the expired portion, which is 1 month, diba money, 1 month expired, divide 12, so 24. So, the carrying amount is 2424. Compare it to the net proceeds. So, ginan sa talugi. Diba? In this problem, this is the net proceeds, 2385. Tapos, the carrying amount of the note receivable is 2424. Ginan sa talugi. Okay. Diba? Lugi ta. Because, ang value 2424, atong nadawat, 2385 ra. Okay. So, the accrued interest receivable. Okay, so how do we account for this? Since this is with recourse, the transaction, since this is with recourse, the transaction is accounted as either conditional sale or secured borrowing. Okay, if it is conditional sale, how do we account for this one? Diba? So, cash, the net proceeds, loss. Diba, yung gigamit diri discounted na. Okay, the note receivable discounted account is deducted from the total notes receivable when preparing the financial position with disclosure of the contingent liability. Okay, so note is paid by maker on maturity. So, inaitabo, gibayaran ni maker. Diba? So, gibayaran ni maker, and sinaitabon August 1, the date of maturity, the note is paid by the maker to the first bank. The contingent liability is extinguished. Of course, diba? Mawala na ang contingent liability. Because, gibayaran naman niya, wala na putay utang. So, nawala ni, the same time, nawala na po ang notes receivable because nabayaran na ni customer. 2-4. What if the note is dishonored by the maker? Wala gibayaran. Therefore, since with recourse, we are liable. So, the note is dishonored by the maker on maturity date. And the entity pays, kita nagbayad ta, maturity value of the note, 2544 plus napag charges nga 6,000. So, the total payment is charged to accounts receivable. So, ang gibuhat na to, so, nag-record ta payment, so, cash, 2550. Debit, accounts receivable. Sir, ganong accounts receivable man na? Diba wala ni bayad si customer? Kita ang ni bayad. Nagbutang tag accounts receivable kay atong collect lahon na kang customer. Kita ang mo collect kang customer or kang maker. That's why that is accounts receivable. Diba? Tapos ato din gi-cancel ang liability because gibayaran naman nato siya. So, that's why we remove the note receivable discounted, then we remove also the note receivable. That is conditional sale. How about secured borrowing? Diba ang kalahian nila, instead of recording loss, interest expense yung gigamit. Instead of recording note receivable discounted, liability account yung gigamit. Pero the amounts are the same. The account title lang ang na outro. There is no objection if the interest expense is net against the interest income or net interest expense of 15,000 because the discounting transaction is a borrowing. So, pwede rin inyo sa net 2439. Pwede rin po delay. So, what will happen if the note is paid by maker on maturity? So, syempre, remove the liability. Oh, di ba nawala na po ang note receivable because nagbayad na si maker. But what if gi-dishonor ang note by the maker? So again, since with recourse, you are liable. So ang gibuhat, di ba, SIM re-entry, dili po dahil lang ang gigamit na account. So, kato lang, discounting of note receivable. Okay, patadira. Okay, so, for purpose of illustration or practice, kadiri lang tataman, tapos, let's call it a day na lang dayon. So, sige daw, let's see if maka, try to answer this problem. Hinainay na ito, nagkagamay na ito. Sige, magpa-oral recitation ko. Sa screenshot sa nako ning 44, tapos kung naay mawala dire, kay magpa-oral recitation. Okay na, screenshot na. Okay na?
Ano sir, kanang principal nga 500,000, then
ani lang sa unsa gani formula to compute for the net proceeds?
Maturity value minus
yes. Discount, maturity value minus discount. Okay, sige. How do you compute the maturity value? What's the formula for maturity value?
Principal principal plus the interest.
Principal
plus the interest.
Okay, plus the interest. How about the discount? What's the formula for the discount? How do we compute the discount?
Maturity value times the discount rate, sir, times discount period.
Okay, maturity value times discount rate times discount period. Okay, give me a number, Miss Lee Barnes.
4, sir.
4, 1, 2, 3. Reyes, Filin Faye Reyes. Thank you, Miss Libarnes. You can now unmute.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So, based on the formulas given, for question number one, what amount of cash was received from the bank? Diba that refers to the net proceeds? So, what is the answer for number one question?
Wait, sa sir.
Okay, sige. Sige. Or ano na lang, give me the maturity value na lang sa, how much is the maturity value for the problem?
$540,000, sir.
Okay, how did you get the $540,000?
Interest, sir, kay $500,000 times 8% times 1 plus $500,000 na principal equals $540,000.
Ah, interest is $500,000 times 8% times
1, sir. 1 year.
1 year. Ah, okay.
Annual interest.
Okay, see. So that is $40,000.
Yes, sir.
Plus the principal of 500,000, so your maturity value is equal to 540,000. Okay, that's correct. Thank you, Ms. Reyes. Give me a number.
7, sir.
7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Nicole Furog. Okay, so you have now the maturity value. So my question is, pila ang discount for this problem? How much is the discount?
Wait lang, sir.
Okay, sige.
$27,000, sir.
$27,000. How did you get $27,000?
$540,000.
$540,000.
10% times 6/12.
Times 6/12. Why 6/12?
Answer. No, wait, answer. Unexpired, sir.
Unexpired portion.
Ay, mo na ikaw answer.
Yes, di ba? Money ang unexpired portion, di ba?
Yes, sir.
Actually, same ang expired og unexpired.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is 27,000. Okay, so this is correct. Thank you, Ms. Furug.
Thank you.
Okay, so since nahatag na sa to ang formula to compute the net proceeds, maturity value is 540,000. This is correct. And you have the discount of 27,000. This is also correct. Therefore, what amount of cash was received or how much is the net proceeds? So we need just to deduct the 540 maturity value and the 27,000 discount. So that is 540 minus 27, that is 513,000. So answer is letter C. So thank you for katong mga nag-answer. Okay, next question number 2. What is the loss on? Okay, what is the loss on note receivable discounting? So first is we need to identify if with recourse ba ni siya or without recourse. So since the problem is silent, di ba wala giingon dira kung with recourse ba ni siya or without recourse. So our assumption is with recourse basis na siya. Di ba? Of course dapat with recourse basis siya kay para pod fair pod sa part sa ni indoor C. So if it is with recourse basis, question na pod karon sir, conditional sale or secured borrowing. So I think it was mentioned here na it must prefer to use the conditional sale with recognition of a contingent liability. So it was stated na it is believed that a discounting of note receivable with recourse is to be accounted for as conditional sale. So since it's silent siya, it's with recourse under conditional sale. So question number two, what is the loss on note receivable discounting? Miss Foro, give me a number. Okay, number 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. 8, 9. 10. Camille Step. Sini, dili man mafuldere. Camille Este. So, say ko nanis. Yes, okay. Sige, so what is the loss on note receivable discounting? First, what is the formula to compute gain or loss on discounting?
Net proceeds minus carrying amount of NR.
Carrying amount of NR. That is your gain or loss. Diba, we have already the net proceeds, 513. My question is, what's the formula of carrying amount of your NR? Okay.
Principal.
Principal.
Plus interest.
Sa ni nga interest? Interest earned. Okay. So, principal plus interest earned. Last question. How do we compute the interest earned? What's the formula for the interest earned?
Principal times rate times time.
Principal times rate times time. Unsa ni nga rate atong gamiton? Based on the problem, 8% or 10%? 8%, which is the nominal rate. Ha? Nominal rate. That's the nominal rate. How about the time? Unsa man ni nga time atong gamiton? Unsa nga time?
Unexpired? A 6 months.
Unsa man ang 6 months?
Expired.
Okay, di ba? The expired term, di ba? So, ang expired term ani 6 months from January 1 to July divide of months. Okay, sige. Thank you, Miss Camille. Give me a number.
22.
Ang grabe kalayo. 1 to 10 ra, 1 to 10.
9.
Sige. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Andahan dyan. Unmute yourself. Okay, sige. Daot akong mic, sir. Sige, akong question. How much is the interest earned? Okay, type your answer with solution. How much is the interest earned? Based on the given formula of Ms. Camille, how much is the interest earned? Okay, interest earned. Pila man na siya? Pila amount na? Sige, ikuhan sa... Aside sa solution, say answer. Ay, daghanag andahan. 20,000. So, ngano nag 180 over 360 ka? Ah, okay. Imong gi days. No, okay. Actually, correct gyapon siya. Okay, so 20,000. So, that's correct now. The interest earned based on the formula. You have, di ba, money ang formula. Principal, 500,000 times 8% times the expired portion, which is 6 months over 12, so that is 20,000. So, my next question is, how much is the loss on note receivable discounting, provided that this is with recourse basis under conditional sale? Pila? 7,000? How did you get the 7,000? Aha, managi ka ng 27,000 minus 20,000. Diba the formula to get the gain or loss is debt proceeds minus the carrying amount of the note receivable. Okay, nanatay net proceeds of 513,000. Pila ang carrying amount? So, the formula for the carrying amount, diba, principal? Aman, gika na si 27,000 o 20,000. So, carrying amount of note receivable principal plus the interest earned. Nakakompute na tag interest earned, pila ang principal? 500,000. Therefore, the carrying amount is 520,000. So, ginan sa talugi, lugi ta og 7,000. The answer is correct, 7,000. But the solution, okay, medyo kuha ng solution. So, 7,000 ang answer ani. So, loss, 7,000. If with recourse and conditional sale siya. What if with recourse tapos secured borrowing? This is the correct solution, ha? This is the correct solution. Because based on the formula, net proceeds minus the carrying amount. So, the net proceeds 513, the carrying amount is 520. Okay. So, another question. What if, same problem, what is the loss on note receivable discounting if with recourse, tapos secured borrowing siya? Say answer. Sige daw, guess daw, kamo, di ba? Kinsay makakuhaan, kinsay. So, okay na, andahan na, thank you. So, type your answers in the chat box. If without with recourse tapos secured borrowing dili conditional sale. Pwede answer anang number 2 if secured borrowing. Okay, nanay nag-answer. Okay, the answer is, okay, the answer is 0. 0 pag with recourse, secured borrowing. Nga naman, di ba, wala ba loss, gain or loss, di ba? We only record interest expense. So, there is no gain or loss, interest expense lang. 7,000 kung with recourse, conditional sale. So in this problem, since silent siya, with recourse siya, tapos conditional sale atong assumption. So 7,000 is the answer. So thank you for those students na nag-participate, no? So let's do this every meeting. Okay, para magpabili ng uban, tapos maminaw gyapon ng uban. Okay, so if you have no questions, napabay pangutana, let's just end our illustration dito kay 5 PM naman po. Okay, nabay questions, naipangutana.